What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Hope that you're having a wonderful day. Sorry for the hurried introduction, but I was listening to Ram On and it almost went into the next song and I was like, oh, I need to stop it because I was working on other stuff on the channel. Okay, Ram, Paul McCartney, Linda McCartney, we're continuing on in our journey. We're going to listen to the tracks Dear Boy and Uncle Albert / Admiral Halsey, of course, off of Ram. So yeah, this has been a great album to listen to. I know we're only three tracks in, but it feels really good, and I'm enjoying this quite a lot, so I hope that you guys are enjoying the ride as well. It is so rainy outside. Florida's really weird with the weather. It can be really cold one day, and then blazing hot the next, clear and sunny 1 hour, overcast and cloudy and rainy the next, as it is right now. I hope that you guys are having a wonderful one. As always, I appreciate you being here. Let's go ahead and get into it. I may stop it in between to talk about the track or not. We'll see. I'll just kind of feel it out. And let's go. This is Dear Boy and leading into Uncle Albert, Admiral Halsey. Let's
go. I guess you never knew, dear boy, what you had found. I guess you never knew, dear boy, that she was just the cutest thing around. I guess you never knew what you had found, dear boy.
No. We got to talk about this one. We got to talk about this one before we move on. No. I have to pause it. And I'm sorry, but we have to pause it. That's a quick song. In 2 minutes and 13 seconds, there is so much in this track. Vocally, this is one of the most dense tracks so far. I mean, you haven't gotten very far, but it's a vocally dense track. It's harmonic paradise. There's a lot. And as soon as it started, this is a track that really, really sounds like a classic Beatles song. Doesn't it have the spirit, the energy, the movement of a Beatles track, but like a classic one? I love the way that the vocals overlap and harmonize with one another. It's very classic Beatles. It's very Beach Boys. It's like a barbershop quartet, but raised in a small town. Like the way that he echoes back and forth and works different verses and lines on top of underlying verses and lines. It's extremely intelligent the way that this song is built. The drumming I even like. I mean, not even like, but the drumming I like too, because I mean, it reminds me of Ringo, to be honest. I didn't even mean to do, did I just do a Beatles? Listen. This is a dense track. There's truly a lot going on in just these 2 minutes. And yet, at the same time, it doesn't feel rushed to me. It doesn't feel like, okay, we only got 2 minutes of studio time in here. Let's get it out. One strength of the Beatles is, of course, their creativity when it comes to the studio and really using the studio, using the environment as part of the music, as another instrument. And I'm just imagining, just by the sound here, that McCartney is doing the exact same thing here. Taking his experience from the Beatles, taking the sounds that, you know, he came up with and the band came up with and what he enjoyed out of it, and just applying it to his own solo music here. Because there's truly, this is a very complex track. This is like being served a soup. No, hold on, back it up. This is like going to a really, really exotic and expensive restaurant that all your friends have told you about, all your family's told you about. You've read reviews, it's high end, it's high dollar, and you get there and everyone says, you have to try this soup, you have to try this soup. And you're like, I'm paying, you know, a lot of money just to sit at this table and I'm gonna get a soup? Like, that's what I'm gonna get? And you get served a soup. Sure, it looks beautiful. It's very quaint. It's very cute. But it's a soup. You're at a high-dollar restaurant for soup. And then you take one spoonful. And all of a sudden, the complicated flavors begin to come through. All of a sudden, you understand why this soup, which may look so simple on first glance, everyone is raving about. That's what I'm saying. That dear boy is. It may seem somewhat simple at a glance. It may seem somewhat straightforward as at a glance, but listen to the colors and the vibrancy in here. That's a lot. Lyrics, I didn't even look at them. I guess you never knew, dear boy, what you had found. I guess you never knew, dear boy, that she was just the cutest thing around. I guess you never knew what you had found, dear boy. I guess you never saw, dear boy, that love was there. And maybe when you look too hard, dear boy, you never do become aware. I guess you never did become aware, dear boy. When I stepped in, my heart was down and out. Is this Genesis? But her love came through and brought me around, got me up and about. Dear boy, when I stepped in, my heart was down and out. Repeats those lyrics. I hope you never know, dear boy, how much you missed. And even when you fall in love, dear boy, it won't be half as good as this. I hope you never know how much you missed. Dear boy, how much you missed. I feel like he's talking about, like, he was with... this other guy had a chance with the girl and messed it up, but now he's like, she's with me now, and ooh, man, you really messed up, because she's amazing. And then he talks about the inspiration that this person, might be Linda actually, meant to him, because he says, when I stepped in, my heart was down and out. He was in a lonely place, but her love came through and brought me around, got me up and about. That other guy's missing out on that love. Let's actually see what the song's about, because I do have the Wikipedia page pulled up here. It says that the song was written during the couple's lengthy holiday on their farm. The lyrics were written by Paul about how lucky he was to have Linda. Yeah, exactly. That's it. That's really what it comes down to there. Man, what a beautiful track. Let's go ahead and like go to the end of it. Let it play just like the last few seconds or so, and we'll let it go into the next track. Which I said was it Admiral Halsey? Uncle Albert, Admiral Halsey. Okay, let's go. The next song, I'll back it up and let that transition go. Can I be honest with you? Like, completely 100% honest? I'm done. I'm done. That song is just bubbling with creativity, bubbling with ideas. He fits them all in. They all work. I don't even know where to begin with this thing. I really don't. The amount of creativity out of McCartney in just this one track, I mean, we've heard it through the album so far, but in just this one track is astonishing. The changes in here, the switch-ups. Also, I do want to say that the production is absolutely impeccable. It's spotless. Everything pops wonderfully. The melodies are coming to light. The bass and the bass is just nice and deep, perfect amount. Everything's just produced extremely, extremely well, which of course you would expect. But so sorry. The song almost begins like a laid-back folk song with a slight smooth jazziness influence on it. and you're immediately set sail on the seas. There's a story going on, which also lends me towards the folk idea. We're so sorry. Love the strings that are brought in. It's a slow jam, right? Uncle Albert is a slow jam. Before we get into whatever comes up next. Now, the question is, I guess, who is Uncle Albert? I'll look into that in a little bit. Let's continue on talking about it. But you also have this coming on. Harmonies arise, and you get someone yelling through a speakerphone or whatever. I just don't know what's going on. This track is too much. There's too much. But listen for the switch up. Hold on. Right there. That's something Mike Oldfield would do. Isn't that switch up cool though? As you come from these sea-bound harmonies, shimmering off the water. It's beautiful. It's inspiring. And then you get Dr. Dre a little bit. And then this trumpet or trombone, whatever it is, this horn. Becomes a very thunderous. Man, this is just a really cool track to listen to. Extremely dynamic. This is rocking. It's jolly. A bit jangly. Can I tell you? Just that moment right there reminds me of Peter Gabriel's delivery in Supper's Ready. Just like, right? He says the butter pie is like a flower, right? And then this retains the beauty in a way of the first part, but turns it more into a folky sea song. These hands, oh, that was bad. Hands across the water. I had to do it lower, you know? But like, that's such a good chorus out of that. Nice big guitar swing here. But then the change up right there. The stylistic choices in here are like, they're so adventurous. I love the adventurous spirit that Paul McCartney is showing in this album. This actually really feels like a celebration of himself, of his wife, of his life at this time. And I love how we're able to construct it. Let's talk about the lyrics here and see if we can interpret them together. So, Uncle Albert, we're sorry, Uncle Albert. We're so sorry if we caused you any pain, but there's no one left at home and I believe it's gonna rain. Or I believe I'm gonna rain. We're so sorry, but we haven't heard a thing all day. We're so sorry, Uncle Albert, but if anything should happen, we'll be sure to give a ring. We're so sorry, Uncle Albert, we haven't done a bloody thing all day. We're sorry, Uncle Albert, but the kettle's on the boil and we're so easily called away. I don't know what it's about, but I'm imagining this person, Uncle Albert, is waiting for something, and whoever's talking to him is like, haven't heard anything yet, so I don't know when we're gonna leave. Oh, the kettle's boiling, I better go get that. But I don't know what the meaning is behind all that just yet. So that's Uncle Albert. Then as we move into Admiral Halsey, hands across the water, hands across the sky, Admiral Halsey notified me he had to have a berth or he couldn't get to sea. I had another look and I had a cup of tea and a butter pie. Butter pie. The butter wouldn't melt, so I put it in the pie, right? hand across the water, hand across the sea. Live a little, be a gypsy, get around, get your feet up off the ground. Live a little, get around. You piece that out and you piece the chorus again. I got no idea what this one's about. Because I was thinking, like, you know, the kettle's on the boil weren't so easily called away. So he was called away and then, like, called away to the military because Admiral Halsey is the next, like, track slash figure here. And the first line says, Admiral Halsey notified me. I don't know. Let me read about it. Maybe we'll find out exactly and see what's going on here. It says that this track is composed of several unfinished song fragments that Paul stitched together in a similar manner to the medleys from Abbey Road. Blah, blah, blah. Paul said Uncle Albert was based on his uncle. He's someone I recall fondly, and when the song was coming, it was like a nostalgia thing. He also stated that I had an uncle, Albert Kendall, who was a lot of fun, and when I came to write Uncle Albert, Admiral Halsey, it was loosely about addressing that older generation. Half thinking, What would they think of the way my generation does things? That's why I wrote the line, "We're so sorry, Uncle Albert." All right, so it's a little bit of a generational perspective on here. As for Admiral Halsey, he's one of yours, an American admiral, referring to Admiral William Bull Halsey. Paul has described the Uncle Albert section of the song as an apology from his generation to the older generation, and Admiral Halsey as an authoritarian figure who ought to be ignored. Okay, so that's what the lyrics are reaching for. I would have definitely had no idea. Anyways, two extremely strong songs. Like, really, really good. I hope that you guys enjoyed this. I really hope that you guys enjoy this, because I'm going to keep on going with this one. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. You can follow me on Twitter. You can support the channel on Patreon. I appreciate you being here, and I hope that you come back tomorrow for whatever else we're listening to. I'm sure it'll be a good time, and I'll see you then. Bye, guys.